talk to us first about how you plan to pursue these legal options. What in particular are you looking for?
Oh, listen, the notion of making love is always a challenge, and you wanted a prenup. In this particular case, it's fairly easy. You want to buy aggressively CBS today because it's down $4 or $5 because of some concerns that some investors or speculators have with regards to the outlook. Independent of that, the merger makes a lot of sense for the two companies as they develop scale and as they develop global reach in a world in which you've got 4 billion smartphones, and which direct to the consumer, in which content plays well, and then you have synergy. So I'm very positive about this deal. Now, I also wear a hat. I have over 1,200 separately managed accounts that own the Viacom voting stock. We've been in the stock since the early 1970s when it was spun off from CBS. We helped Sumner when he did his deal with Paramount, when he did the proxy fight on Viacom, and we've known Sumner when he was in the theater business. So we like to be an owner. However, we would feel that our voting stock in Viacom should get a little extra premium. But, you know, when you put the numbers together, it's not a big number. It's only 10 million shares. If they pay us $5, it's only $50 million. That's less than the severance they paid for some of the executives that left Viacom or CBS. So we just think we have to figure out a way to have the morally right thing to do for our clients, and hopefully it's legally appropriate.
Have you heard from any of the other shareholders that, of course, aren't within the family?
No, I have not talked to Sherry for a while, but I know her address because that's where she had a meeting with Ionello. It was in the paper, so, we know how to find her. But I've waited till this deal was announced rather than talking to her in advance.
Why do you think the voting shares came down so much since the deal was announced, Mario?
Well, because they're not giving you any premium for the VIA versus the VIAB. The VIA is where the vote is. The VIAB isn't. But when the dust settles, you're going to have 615 million shares of a stock. It is a bargain. And there'll be 53 million voting shares of that amount. National Amusement will own 43. And my clients will own half of the balance that are not in public hands. So basically, we will continue to have a strong voice at the table. And we will monitor everything as we've done for the last 20 or 30 years, all within the framework of the rules and regulations. And in this particular case, we're not asking for a lot.
Mario, I know you said that you've been in this stock for a long time, since the 1970, as you said it. But this is the risk, I suppose, of holding stock when most of the voting rights are held by 80% of them are controlled by one family.
So we made a lot of money with Madison Square Garden, which is owned by the Dolans, and they control the vote. Malone controls a lot of the voting stock and all of the media mogul companies. If you want to do that, then you shouldn't own Amazon, you shouldn't own any of the Googles,
exactly,
and so on. So I'm not overly concerned of that. So I think that's a straw person. We think that Sherry will do the right thing. She had a problem in putting this together. We'll see.